Hey there, I am Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So I'm very excited to make this video because UiPath has yesterday announced their new UiPath apps for public review, and now everyone of us can use it. So I tried my hands on that, and it is a very interesting product by UiPath that has been launched, and it has, I think it can be used in n number of use cases. So this video is particularly about exploring completely the UiPath apps, see what are its features, what are the functionalities, what can we do, and we will create very basic app because this is just for the exploring purpose. Later I will be making videos where we'll be building different kinds of apps, and even I will be learning through that. So without any delay, let's get started. Now, first, let me show you the announcement by UiPath yesterday that was on forum. So, okay, it's here. So, first, let's see the announcement, then we'll see what are the features, how we can use them, how we can create your first app in this video. So, UiPath apps public review. You see 10 hours. It's just been 10 hours they've announced that. And now you see over here. UiPath apps is now available in public review. Check out the full UiPath app preview announcement. And this is how you see, this is the particular app built by them. And also this was first shown in UiPath DevCon. And it was said that it will be available by the next end month for public review, and here it is. So this is the quick start guide and documentation. So if you need any documentation, you can just go to forum.uipath.com. You will see directly this particular UiPath Studio documentation. So now what we'll do is we'll go directly to the app platform and we'll start creating our first app and see what are the functionalities available. So now, as we know, we use our this cloud portal. So what you need to do is you need to just go to cloud.uipath.com to use the apps. Now I have already signed in using my account, so there's no requirement to make any changes from my side. I need not log in or nothing like that. Now you see the option is available over here, apps. So when I click on apps, the platform opens for me, the app studio. We have UiPath Studio. Similarly, this is called the app studio. Now you see over here, this is my app studio where I can see all the apps I create. This was the one which I created yesterday. I was just exploring it completely. Now what we are going to do is, so if you have not created any app, it will show a message over here. You haven't created any apps. Please create your first app. Something like that message will be. But now since I've already created, I can directly run it. So let me show what I have created. It's just a very basic one to check whether two fields have the same number or not. So here I'm going to put 10 and here 20. Submit. Not equal. So I'm going to dismiss it. Now this is the small app I have built just to test the functionalities and learn them. 10, 10, and it is going. Now this is the message box over here. As you can see, it is coming from top. Now I have given the name and it automatically goes after 5 seconds. So this is the thing. This is the small app which I have built. So we are going to see all these functionalities available. Okay. UiPath apps, YouTube video. So let me create the new app for myself. Okay. So this is the interface that is there. So let's explore the interface first and then we'll dig into more deeper. Now you see, when I created my first app, 3 sections are already created. One is the main page, one is the layout, and one is the container. So the main page is your complete app page, the gray skin which you can see screen. Sorry. Now layout is your actual part of your app, the particular section. So it can be 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I can keep on adding them. Okay. So once I, and now this is my container wherein I will be adding. So as you saw over here, this particular part, this is my container which I have expanded and given the functionalities inside that. So let me just drag this and you see it looks similar, like it's there over there in my exploring app. So it's over here. Now if I want to add similarly down, what I can do is I can just click this and it will be added over here. So this is my, okay, so I by mistakenly deleted all of them. You see, there was container one. So there are two containers now in my single page. Now, this is my only first page of my app. Now, if you want to add one more page, now this, we added a container in the same page below that. But what if you want to add new page? So new page option is over here, process, control. We are going to see all these options do. Don't worry about any of the thing if you don't know or if you haven't explored yet. We will be seeing everything. So this is now my container. Now, general are the properties. If you put some text box, a button or something, if you want to keep it hidden or you want to keep it disabled, you can select this particular properties. These are the general properties. Now going to events. Events are basically what you want to do on click of that button or on a value getting filled in that text box. So suppose if you are filling a value in the text box and you want to assign it to the variable, how you can do that? Even here we can declare variables like we used to do it in our UI Path Studio. So here also you have an option to declare the variables. Here you also have an option to give if else condition to open page, open URL. What if you want to open the next page? So this is right now my first page. What if you want to open a next page on click of some button? You can definitely do that. As you can see, right now I've removed that functionality from my exploring app. But if I click on next page, it will take me to the next page of the app. So we have like many times when we use it, while signing in initially, we click enter our email ID, password, then next, then it shows some guidelines, then we click on next. And now, so we saw what is general, what is events. General is basically to give a general properties. When you drag something over here, if you want to change the name of that field, you can do all that things in general. We'll see how you can do that. Don't worry. In events, you can create rules. So let me just show you what rules do we have with us. So I've clicked on create rule and you see over here. If then else, open a page. Open a page, not some web page, but the actual page of your app. Open a URL. Close pop-up over bottom sheet. Show message, show or hidden spinner. Set values, start process. So these are different types of conditions you say available with us. Now, if you want the documentation for that, it's over here. You can see these are the input, but see over here. If you want to learn each of them in detail, rule, if then else, open page, open URL, show page, show or hide spinner, set value, start process. So these are the different kind of events and rules available with us in our App Studio. Now moving forward, so these are the rules. If I click if then else, you see over here, I have compare, I have group different options. So we'll see how we can use all of them. Let me just close it for now. Okay. Now going to the style. You can keep it vertical, horizontal, whatever style you want the layout. If you want to add some background color, okay. So let's change it to something yellow. You see the color is changed over there. If I take it to blue, change to blue. And you see these are the different colors available. For now, let's keep it white. We are not going to do any designing for now. And also you see, you can give the hexadecimal value of the color. It's not necessary that you have to just select from the up one. If you just Google some color and you get the hexadecimal value, you can do that. Now, if you want to add a border, there is no border. Let me put 2 and 2. So this is the border we have for our app. If I put 9, you see, I have this kind of border. And radius, let me put it 5. So in this way, I can add the border. You can change the border color as well. We have that feature as well. Going to font. Font can be whatever you want to select. There are different fonts available like we have in our normal. Padding. You have padding. Let's see, change it to 8. And you see this changed over here. If I change this, You see, it came a bit inside. Now, moving forward, we have the margin. So, if I want to keep some margin, let's do it 5. You see, the margin was changed. And 5. So, this is how you can give the margin. And the size, full width, if you want to give some specific height or something. Now, this is full. I'm just clicking it on 100%. So this is how you can completely customize your app. It's just not like you have text box and you have buttons and you have something else. It's like you can give it a very, you can make it very attractive. Like we try to build our simple apps. Obviously, it's not going to be like Android apps or something like that. But considering the features provided over here are very much interesting and useful to use. Now you see, I can change the size and everything. Now you see it's in center. Now if I go over here, you see it came over here. So this is how you can completely customize your app, give it different kind of borders, give it different kind of colors. If you want to give your page a color, you can do that. If you want to give some other styling, you want to give background color, you want to give border, you want to give margin, padding, every HTML element that you give for your app is provided in UiPath App Studio. So this is very interesting and very exciting. Now let's see what are the types. Now we saw basically what is App Studio, how you can create your app, what are main page, layout, container, what are different properties available in general, events, and style section. Now what we are going to do is we are going to see different type of controls available. First, let's see them in our documentation. Let me just collapse this. Okay, no problem. So now you see, I have three types of controls: container, input, and display. So now let's see all of them in our main page studio, App Studio. Now, for adding a control, the first thing you need to do is you can't keep a click on main page layout. You have to click your container. And then only you should click add new control, because the thing is, I am trying to add that particular control in this section. I'm not adding it over somewhere else. So this what you have to keep in mind is while creating an app, you have to click on container and then click on add new control. Now, once I click on that, you see I have different options available over here. There is input, there is display, there is containers, and there is icons. So now let's see what we have in input. In input, we have a button that we keep in our apps. We have a checkbox, we have a date picker, we have a drop down, we have a slider, we have a switch, text area, text box. So these are the very basic elements that we use or that we generally have in our apps. Now you can use all of them in your UiPath App Studio. And this is very interesting. Like you have all the directly readily available features in App Studio, in UiPath Studio also, we used to drag the activities and use them. The same concept is kept over here, but just the context is changed. Now here, there you used to build your workflows and bots. Here you can build your complete app. So if I drag button, you see I have the button over here. Now saying in general, as I told you, in general, you can change the text and all. So now I have button. Let me give it as submit. Okay, so this is how the value is changed. You see, now I click on button icon. I can give if I want any submit icon search. Okay, so you see in icons you have different kind of list. You can keep this. If I drag this over here, you see it is automatically inside our submit button. You need not do anything like dragging and dropping. You just drag in the icon section and it's done. So let me close this. Value binding. Now value binding is the concept where you add variables to your text box or some other actions that you want to do. In that case, value binding is used. So this is how we can create a button, your first button in UiPath App Studio. Let me delete this. I can click on container and see the controls. After that, I have a date picker. Let's see the date picker. Select the date. The variable you put over here will have the value of your date. So this is how you can use the value binding and variables. You see app variables. So if I create a variable date and I just put it over here. So this variable is going to have the value of my date. Again, clicking on container, add new control. After that, what we have is we have a slider, we have a switch, we have a text area, we have a text box. Let's see how a text box looks like. So it is simple value binding hint text. What you want the user to enter here? First name I'm going to write. So this has the first name. Now, if you are creating an app where you want to take user details and create a maybe an ID card or something like that, you can use this particular option. Container, then saying what's the other. So these are all the different input functions we have in our UiPath App Studio. Moving ahead to display advanced list. You can have the data source values over here. So this is to display a complete list. You can see in the icon over here, it is shown how it will display the values. So now we don't have any list created, but you can use a list. You see, these are the three different sections. Okay, so let me just delete it for now. Container, add new control, and display. Then we have divider. If you want to create sections, now when we go to fill up web form or something on a website, we see there's one part, then there's a line to fill the second part, then there's a line to fill the third part. So this is how you can use that. If you want to add some header, now let me put it as UiPath apps exploring UiPath app studio. Now this is my heading. If I want to save it in some variable, I can do that, but I don't want to save it. Events, there is no rule right now for this and it is not even required. I want to put it in center. I want to make it headline one. Now you see the size is bigger of that particular text. If I want to give some margin, if I want to increase the size, I can do all that things, but I'm not going to do anything. Okay, so now moving ahead, let's keep the heading, let's not remove it, and going back to container. What other options we can add a label if we want. This is the label and this is the way it looks like. Okay, let me remove label as well. Going back to container, add new controller. Okay, now what we have is we can insert a table. We can show a complete table if we want. We can add columns, name, and phone. So I have two options over here. Now to change the values of this, you can, as we saw over here, we have a data source. If I give some data source, which is in the table format, the values will be automatically updated over here. But right now, just exploring the functionalities, so not adding any data source or anything. So why I'm not including everything in one video is because we'll explore them one by one. This is just we are exploring and creating a basic app. Now after this, we have containers. If you want, now we already have a container. You see, this is the container that we have. If you want to use some other container layout or a page container, you can use this kind of containers in your apps. So this was the third thing that we have. So we saw what were inputs in that. We had text area, checkbox, radio buttons, date picker, and everything that in display. Okay, so in display, I forgot to show, you can add images as well. You can give the value over here or you can give the URL over here. Let's go. UiPath Studio images. Okay, so let me just search UiPath logo.
copy image address and let's see whether we are able to get the image or not. Paste. Okay, so this is very amazing thing. I think which we can do is just by giving a logo, you were able to studio. Okay, so we are not having the logo over here. App Studio. Okay, it's not there still over here, but you see, just I copied the URL and I have it over here. What I'm going to do is, okay, so we have this events, no events. I want to keep it in the center. No, maybe at the corner only, it's fine. Size, it is auto. Margin, width, I can give any if I want. Now, why I'm not able to put it exactly beside this? Because this particular thing has covered the upper part. Now, if I move this to this side, still you see the size is not matching, so I cannot move exactly beside that. So let's keep it in this way. Okay. So you can add from your desktop as well. So okay, so I have a community logo over here. Let's add that. Now it is uploading and I'm able to put this. And I'm going to remove this particular thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this below over here. Exploring UI path apps. Okay, so now this looks very interesting. If you want to add your own, say, branding logo or something in App Studio, you can definitely do that just by selecting the image as we do to send someone via mail or anything. So this is also very interesting features. So some of them I am exploring currently while making this video. Okay, so we have added the image and what we have later is the icons. So in icons, icons are basically whatever you want to do. As we saw, we had on the submit button the similar way it's over here. If there are shopping cart, location, there are many of them. So this is like according to our requirements, whenever and whatever you want. You see, I think there are more than 100 or 150 icons I can see over here. Wi-Fi. So if you are creating a app for some hotel or something, and if you want to show the available, what we say, something is available, so you can do that. Okay, so let me scroll up. So now what we are going to do is let's create something. I exactly don't have anything in mind, but let's see what we can create. So what I'm going to do is let me try putting this over here. And whether I can put a text box beside it. No, I can't put it beside it. I have to put it up. Okay, so let me remove this, going back to the container. So this is what we are doing, is everything we are doing in one page. Now what we'll do is let's create two fields, username and password. So text box one. And cool. Okay, so first let's add this over here. Enter username and the value. Let me delete this. This value will be stored in username. Okay, now let's go to container. Let's add one more text box. Enter password. This will be stored in the variable password. Okay, so we have done these two things. Now, if you want to add some event style, but we are not going to add, we are So what I am trying to do is okay. So I think I did some mistake. Okay, I think I made some mistake over here. I will have to add that again. This is going to be enter username. And it is going to have the value user. Now going back to container, add new control, text box. Enter password, value or binding. Enter the password. Now what we are going to do is we are going to have a button. On the button, first let me change the name of this login. Add an icon, search for an icon. Okay, so icon, I think I will have to search by myself only. So let's use this one. This is for account box. This is for, okay, let's use this, no problem. So what I am going to do is on this submit button, I'm going to create a rule. Now if this login is successful, and that what rule we are going to keep is username and password should be the same. Now if this is the same, we'll see what we want to do. Now going to events and create a rule. If then else, if we are going to compare, the value one is going to be the username and value one is going to be the password. Okay, so on click of this, what we are going to do, if they both are same, then we are going to open a page. Okay, so I think I did not create a main another page. Okay, so let's first create this. Cancel. I'm going to the main page. You see, I have an option over here. Add page. Okay, this is the new page. Now I need to go to add new control. Going to the containers. And first I have to add the container layout. So this is the same one that we saw, which we had initially with us. Okay, and here I'm going to click on container and let us give this login successful. Style, this is going to be heading one. It is going to be in the center. I want to reduce the size a bit. Okay, so this looks fine. Okay, so now we have our page with us, and on this login button we were editing the rule. Edit rule. What page to open? It should open the new page for me. And if it is not same, then what I want to do is show a message. It should be warning, login and copy, username and password do not match. So this is the complete rule we have created. So if username is equals to password, now in equals also you have different. It's not comparing equal only, but you have different options as well. So if it is, then I want to open the new page that is going to be my login successful. If not, then what I want to display the user is a warning. And you see there is the position available, top or bottom. Okay, so top. And it will auto dismiss after 5 seconds. So this I have saved it. let me close. So what we have done is we have created our first login app in UiPath Studio, and you say it is looking very amazing to me. Let me just reduce the size of it. And I think we shall take this in the center. I think center should look good. And this as well. Okay, this looks good. Okay, so this is the default size. Now we have created our first page, and in the new page, it is login successful. And also one more thing. Okay, so we have the style for submit buttons as well. If I go over here, solid. I have this kind of thing, you see. Start. Outline. But I think this button looks cool over here. Okay. So I think we are good to go. And let's preview our app to see first it is working properly. If then we'll publish it and then run it. Okay. Okay. So you see, this is why I didn't publish it directly and kept it for preview. So I will have to scroll this a bit. These borders also don't look good. Let me just go to my container. Borders. Okay. So I think I added in layout. Font is fine. Padding is fine. So main page. Okay. So let's remove the border, make it zero. Okay, this is fine. Let's preview it. I think the image size is not getting fit because it's a very big image. Yeah, you can see it. Exploring UiPath App Studio. So I'm going to write path, and I'm going to write hello. Username and password do not match. Okay, this is great. This is very great. I'm too excited to make my first app. And you see, it was same and it took me to the next page. So we were successfully able to create our first app, guys. And this is superb. I think I don't know why I'm getting this happy, but I am just loving it the way these features have been provided. And let's now publish it. What are we waiting for? So I've clicked on publish, and you're saving your app and publishing it. Now our app has been successfully published, and we can run it directly from the app section. So let me close my exploring part and go to the App Studio. Now you see UiPath App Studio. This is my version 1. You can still edit it. You can duplicate, share. And let's just run it. Let's run it and see how does that look. So you see, this looks very interesting, very exciting. Let me enter my name, Parth Doshi. Now you see, I am just entering Parth. Username and password do not match. Now I'm going to enter Doshi. Why do they still don't match is because there is a space as well. It is comparing that part as well. So Parth Doshi. And login successful. So this is it. I think this much is, it's already, I think, more than 15 minutes we have been exploring UiPath Studio. So I hope you enjoyed this complete video and you learned something very basic and all the features that are provided in the App Studio. Don't worry, I'm going to make many videos on App Studio. You will be at least seeing 10 to 15 videos in this complete playlist, and you are definitely going to enjoy it. And we have successfully created our first app as well, that is a login app along with the validations. So I hope you learned something new and very interesting in this video. Please do subscribe to my channel. A 1 subscribe from you motivates me to create more and more content every day. My channel name is Parth Doshi, Learning by Doing. Have a great day, and thank you for watching the complete video and having the patience and exploring the complete UiPath Studio. Thank you.